guys, Isabella here from Ella Photography. So I figured that I would show you guys a little bit of the process that goes behind taking pictures, retouching photos once you're done taking the pictures. This is Maverick. He's 14 years old. His mom, Kelly, wanted to take pictures of him for one last time before he needed to be, you know what I mean. Anyways, he's suffering from multiple, he's suffering from multiple conditions because he's lived a long life and, you know, anyways, it's a very sad story. I don't want to get too into it or else I'm going to start getting teary. So we did the pictures yesterday at the park, and I absolutely love them. They turned out really, really great. This is one of them, one of my favorites, actually. It's him just staring at a group of people. Now, we don't have a leash on him right now. However, Kelly here, his mommy, is holding him by the collar. So this part here is not very amazing, but... I don't even know if this is recording. Is this recording properly? Let's see. First. I think it is. So let's just keep talking. So she's holding the collar here. It's not an amazing picture of Kelly. However, we're going to be removing her after we are done removing the retouching the first process. So we are here in Lightroom. This is Lightroom 3. I usually start doing my post-processing in Lightroom, and then once the coloring and everything that I want is done, I bring it into Photoshop for the really detailing and cloning out items from the pictures, and if ever I want to add some actions to it, I also do that. Okay, so let's start. This is a picture. So first, what we're going to do is that I crop the photo first. The reason for this is because I want to know exactly what I'm working with. So you'll see here that the horizon is really crooked. That's a little bad habit that I have. So I'm going to take in the crop tool right here, I'm going to take this little ruler and I'm going to click it across the horizon and make it straight. Now, I like how he's completely on the side. I have a habit of shooting my subjects in the third, oh my god, I'm forgetting my words. I apologize, it's very hard for me to keep to English rather than switching languages all the time, but I'm trying to make you guys a favor. So I always shoot them to the side because I like the negative space type of pictures. So this is what I did. So maybe I'm going to push in a little bit more to the angle here, the rule of thirds. There you go. So this is the cropping that I'm going to keep. So you'll see that this picture is really flat. It was very cloudy yesterday and there's no sunlight whatsoever, which is amazing for shadows. However, it makes your image a little bit flat. Sorry, I'm doing something really bad. I'm actually drinking coffee while I'm talking. Okay, so let's see here. I really want to see if I'm recording this. Okay, so yes, I am recording. Okay. So this is very complicated. Let's keep going. So this is the picture. We cropped it down. Now, first thing we're going to do, given that it's a little cold, I'm going to warm it up a little bit here. Let's see. I'm going to keep it like that. I like this here. Then we're going to play with the exposure. It's a little bright. So what I do basically, it's very easy. I just go down, all the way down to each command, and then I play around with it until I'm satisfied with the product. It's I don't do anything very complicated. I'm going to recover the lost parts here. And you could also see, by playing with it completely, you'll see the difference, and then you could judge what you like. So I'm going to put it here. Here's fine. Okay, so then, let's see. Do I want to fill the light? No, not really. The blacks are good. Maybe I'll just do it a little bit to fill in the blacks here. Do-do-do-do-do. Just a sec. So, you're going to have to be patient with me. Okay, maybe I like it a little bit more towards here. Exposure, you're good. Okay, we're going to keep it this way. Okay, so this makes a very big difference. So I'm going to put it down to maybe minus 15. Okay. There you go. So that's good. So here I have. That's good. Then I'm going to recover. That's good. I like this. This, maybe I'm going to put it up a little bit more. The light. I'm very nitpicking right now, but it's all good. It's for you guys, right? So I'm going to go down here and then next contrast. I love putting contrast in my photos. You'll see the difference. This is no contrast and this is very big contrast. It just creates a lot of dynamic. I like this. So already it's looking better. Let's go. So that's awesome. Okay, so let's keep going down. Clarity. Clarity, basically, you'll see the difference here. This is no clarity, so it's very muddy and gross. And then here you'll see very clarity. So don't confuse this for sharpness. It's not the same thing. Clarity will... Let's go a little bit closer. We'll basically take the surrounding pixels and... I'm not going to say sharper. I'm not remembering the exact term for it. But basically, we'll just define it a little bit more. So I don't want too much of this. I'm going to put 10. Let's go back. Do-do-do. There you go. Okay, so just 10 makes a little difference. Hardly anything, to be honest, but we'll put it just like that. And I'm also gonna put a little bit of vibrance, a little bit, but we're gonna play with it a little bit more when it comes to the colors. So the vibrant, basically, it's very clear what it is. I'm just gonna put a little bit, hardly anything. It's very subjective, eh, when it comes to processing. And then the saturation, I'll just boost it a little bit as well. That you see the difference right away. So I'm gonna put it just to 15. Okay, so I like to go back often just to see the difference. Okay, so this is my favorite part, the tone curves. So this basically plays with the lights and the shadows and will define how you want your blacks and how you want your whites. So for here, I'm gonna, when you go towards the bottom of the curve, it will define how muddy you want your blacks. And then in here, it will define how you want your whites to appear. So that's very clear. The more details that you want, the more specific that you want it, the more bullets that you should put. I always keep it like this. And the more general you want it, then keep bullets, keep less bullets, I'm sorry. So if ever you put a bullet and you say, oh no, I made a mistake, what do I do? Just grab it and then pull it out. Grab it and then pull it out. Okay, so here's what I'm gonna do. Let's see, let's play around. So I play around a lot. I like having my blacks a little bit more muddy than usual. So I'm gonna pull this, I'm gonna pull this a little bit higher here. Okay, here I'm gonna put it a little bit more down. I like it. I'm going to put one in the middle just to define the difference between the two. Maybe I'll just rise it a little bit more. Maybe not a little bit, a little bit less. And then here I'll pull it out. And I'll put this one a little bit higher to see what's the difference here. Okay, I like that the whites are a little bit more white. But maybe I'll put this down a little bit more. Okay, how's that? Oh, it's looking good. It's looking good. Okay, so that's done for now. For now. If ever you decide that you're not happy with something, you know, don't be shy to always go back. Actually, you know what? I'm going to go back already. The white's a little bit too white. Okay. So, this is here the colors. So you'll have the difference of hues if you want to change a specific color. Maybe red's not the greatest idea to show you guys. Here, the green. If ever you wanted more yellow, or if you wanted more cyan. There you go. Okay, then you can change it through this panel here. By the way, if you want to put things back to zero, if ever you made a mistake like this, but you want to put it back to zero easily, you have two choices. You can either do the complicated way and put it to zero, or you could just double-click on the actual name, and it goes back. Okay, so we don't want to change any colors, because we like the colors here. You have also the colors here, which you can change basically from dark to light. Let's say if you want to play with the reds, the oranges, the yellows, the greens, just to show you, you can change it. You can boost the saturation of the green if you want, or even the luminance of it. I'm good with it though. Or you could just convert it from to black and white with this panel here, and then play with the colors once it's black and white. But we're gonna keep this one in color because I like pet photography in color. I find they deserve to be in color, so. Okay, what am I gonna do here? I am going to play around here with the colors, the saturation, because I think I want the green to be a little bit brighter. Just a little bit. And then here, actually, the green is not that green. So I'm gonna have to boost the color of the yellow as well to be able to define. Okay, so I'm just gonna put it up a little bit, tiny bit. So that's done. I'm happy with that. Are you guys happy? Yeah, we're happy. Okay, let's keep going. Split toning. Split toning, what is split toning? Basically is putting a color on your highlights and your shadows. So let's give you an example, very crazy example. If let's say I want to put my highlights in green, I would boost here the saturation, and then all my highlights have become green. If I want to, let's say, instead boost my shadows and put my shadows to pink or purple, then all my shadows, all the dark parts, will become purple. Now, I don't often go very crazy with this. However, I do play around with it a little bit. So let's see what we can do here. So here is nothing. So let's boost the saturation first a little bit. Let's say 20. Okay, except I don't like here the beige. So I'm going to go and play with it a little bit and put it a little bit more towards. There you go. So basically, I put a little bit of a warm tone on my highlights. So if you want to see the... How do I do this? Before, no, wait, maybe I should do this. So I put it to, so this is what it was. Here, about. Okay, so this was before. So see, the areas here are a lot colder, and by boosting it a little bit, it became much warmer. You could see it here in the trees over here. Okay, so I'm happy with that. If ever you want an idea as to, like an example as to what to work with, you can click here on the color and they'll give you examples. These are like mostly the most used. If you want something that's cold, you could go here. There's the warmer ones, which is basically what I chose. There's a little bit of a yellow tone, and then there's a gray, which doesn't do much. It just neutralizes everything, so I'm going to keep it here. I like it, I like it. Then we're going to go back here. The balance is basically how much of the colors that you want. So you want to balance it more towards the highlights or more towards the shadows. I don't want to play, I don't play with that a lot. And then here, do I really want to play around with the shadows? No, I don't. So I'm going to keep it to zero so that the blacks are blackish gray. Okay. blackish brown, sorry. The color of his fur. Okay, so we keep going. So let's close these for now. Okay, detailing. Detailing is sharpening. In case you guys didn't notice, I love my subjects sharp. This was taken with a 50mm 1.4, one of my favorite lenses, prime lens, and makes everything really, really, really sharp. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna make it even sharper, but without going too crazy. So this is the eye. I'm gonna go actually a little bit closer to here so I can see it in a lot bigger. I guess that's the biggest that it can go. Yep. Okay, so there's two different ways. In sharpening in Lightroom is very detailed. I love it. If you press, you have the choice of either going like this, which would be just seeing the amount of sharpening that you want, or by pressing Alt or Option on your Mac. I'm guessing that it would probably be Alt on the PC. You can see that it changes here to reset. You see it? Beep, 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 beep. Okay, so this what it basically does is that when you go down and play around with your sharpening, you could see it in more detail what exactly you're sharpening. So for the amount, it turns the image to black and white. For the radius, you will be able to see that by pushing it here, that's what basically becomes sharper. So that's a little bit too much for me. I don't want it to go too crazy. I want it to make look natural. With the detailing, it would also show you the one of the same things, but except it will go more into detail. So I'm going to keep it here. And the masking, it will go from sharpening the entire image to sharpening specific details. So basically everything that's in black will not become sharpened. So I like to keep it a little bit more general. There you go. So you'll see that my dog, Maverick, will become very sharp, and then the back will only choose a few detailings of the sharpness. So there you go. So I like that a lot. Not bad at all. Pew. There you go. Perfect. Now, the last thing here is I could either vignette everything, which usually I like vignette it just a little bit, just creating that natural vignette that usually my lens will create on its own. So I'll just put a little bit more. Actually, given that my lens already has vignetting, you see it here, you actually see it a little bit more here. It's a little bit darker. However, I do apply a profile on lens corrections to remove distortion. So for me, given that I use a popular lens, which is the 50mm 1.4, by clicking the enable button here, it does it automatically. So it chooses my lens, the one that I used, and then it fixes everything. It also removes, as you can see, the vignetting around that I actually like. So what I'm gonna do is that I'm gonna press the enable button, but I'm gonna re-add my vignetting. All right, so that I'm pretty happy with. Do I want to put it down a little bit more? Once everything is done and you played with your curves and everything, you could go back and try to see if you want to maybe do it a little bit, you know, darker, or maybe even... I am pretty happy with it though. So I'm gonna keep it like this for now. So this is my image. Yay! Before, after, before, after. So when you go and go down the list of everything and then play around with every option basically, you'll see that it does a really big difference to a very flat image to bringing out the dog. I could go play in the other, what's it called? Oh my god, I'm so sorry. I could be playing in the other menus, as in healing or cloning or, you know, red eye correction. Mind you, the dog doesn't have any red eye. or playing with masks, or even with a brush. However, I like doing that in Photoshop. The reason being is that I'm just used to it. So you could either learn to do it on here. Obviously, it's not as detailed as Photoshop, but a lot of people like doing it. Or you can just learn. So given that I'm done here, I am going to open this into Photoshop. In order to remove Kelly, Mommy Kelly, from the image, because everything else is I'm very happy with. So it's gonna take a second and a half to open my program. My computer's pretty slow, unfortunately, so let's keep going. Sip of coffee. It would be awesome to know if you guys would like videos like this a little bit more often. It's a nice way for me to have videos and maybe have you guys on my quiet page. So if you like it, be sure to like it on Facebook, and then also to show people that you liked it, and also subscribe to YouTube. I should be saying this at the end, but you know, since it's opening. Okay, so here's my image. I'm gonna put it full image for you guys. So this is my poppy, not mine, but this is Maverick. When it comes to grass and trees and just greenery, it's quite easy to remove objects because the ground or the sky or whatever it is very uneven. There's no direct pattern to it, so it's easy, you'll see. What I'm gonna do actually is that this area here, you'll see that it's very empty and nothing really is going on here. So I'm gonna remove this little paper using my clone stamp. I use it at 100 only for these, for grass, because you want it to look exactly like its neighbor pixels, I would say. So you do that at 100. And I'm just gonna grab this area here, and then remove that red, and I think it's a paper on the ground or something. Given that I used my 50 millimeter and the depth of field is very shallow, it's good. It's actually easier to retouch because it doesn't have to be even, nobody will notice. Okay. There you go. Okay, so the paper has been removed. Once that's done, I'm gonna take my selection tool and basically take all this, copy, and then paste it onto a different layer. So obviously you don't see the difference, but there it is. Then using that, I will transform it and flip it to bring it all the way here. Okay? Now, you see where I'm going with this? Obviously Maverick is covered now. But what I can do is, instead of deleting, I will mask it to be able to just go back to it if ever I make a mistake. So here I have my layer, and then it's all white. So I'm going to take my black brush at a 100 and everything, because I'm deleting directly, and I'm going to bring back Maverick. Now, like I was saying, the grass is very uneven, so it's very easy to blend grass within itself. A little tail. Okay, and I will play around with the trees. To blend that. Isn't that easy? So there's Kelly, and Kelly's gone. There's Kelly, and then she's gone. So here, I missed a little part. There you go. So the biggest part is done. I'm actually gonna take my white brush, maybe bring it a little bit closer to Maverick. There you go. So that the horizon goes all the way to the edge. Given that it's fur, it doesn't have to be completely even. So Kelly is gone. It was very easy. The only part that's left here is her hand under the collar. So how do I remove that? So here I'm going to flatten it. Well, first, what I'm going to do is that I'm going to create a snapshot of this in case I need to go back to it for any reason at all with the layers, okay? Then here, I'm going to flatten it and keep going. Now, I just noticed something. You see this? Oh, this little white spot? I missed it. So make sure that you delete everything properly so that there's no spots showing up. Okay. So to remove this hand, how do I do that? Well, it's actually really easy. You'll take your clone stamp, and also I'm going to keep it again at 100 because I really want to delete it 100%. The only reason that I would go, I would bring down the opacity really low is if I'm working with skin or if I don't want to make it too obvious that I'm transforming something like on skin or clothing or so on and so forth. But here it's very direct, so I want it to be 100%. So again, I'm going to have to remove the hand from this area here. And you'll see here that we have a nice fur pattern on this side that looks exactly like that. So I'm going to take it, I'm going to bring down my size, and I'm going to copy here. I'm just going to brush it a little bit. I'm going to even go a little smaller. And I could even take it from up here. And I'm just going to brush it. Like it up here better. Okay, and also here you're gonna have to go really close, bring it down, and remove it. Okay, now once the hand is not there and you bring it out, you don't really see the fact that it's pulled that much. If this really bothers you and you say, okay, well, the collar is weird because it looks like it's crooked, or how do I straighten it? You can go into, given that it's a small correction, you can go into the liquify tool. Once it opens, go closer here. Now I'm not using any shortcuts because I want you guys to understand really where I'm going. Bring down your size. That's good. And oops, apologize for that. And then use this warp tool to just move it a little bit. I'm going to bring it up a little bit. There you go. And by doing that, it's going to change your image. Don't go too crazy because it really shows you're actually moving around pixels when you're doing this. So you don't want to do it too crazy or else it's going to show that you're modifying your image a lot. There you go. That's good. I'm happy. Ta-da! So you're done. This is Maverick without Mommy. By using just the stamp tool, copy paste, and a little bit of the liquify tool, you were able to remove Mom and create an awesome image of Maverick just sitting in the grass. So hope you guys liked this video. You know what? Since I'm concluding here, this thing is really bothering me. So I'm gonna take the stamp tool at 100 and just go over it once. There, so. So thank you for this, for listening to my video. Hope you guys liked it. If you did, please let me know, cause I'm more than willing to show you guys a little bit more on how I retouch images and how I do my post-processing afterwards. So let me know and subscribe to YouTube on my channel if you're interested in getting them in directly notified. Sorry, if you're interested in directly getting notified of my videos, or like it on Facebook to show your peeps that you just watched this video of me. So yeah, that's it. Does it show that it's my first video? I don't know how to finish this. I'll talk to you guys later. Bye.